morning, Himmels.
Good morning.
Welcome to worship, and I especially want to welcome all of the Girl Scouts who are here joining us this morning for our Girl Scout Sunday. And we appreciate your being with us and helping with our service today. This is the last Sunday in the Easter season. Next Sunday will be the Festival of Pentecost. And just a few additions to the bulletin about things that will be happening this morning. We will have special music in our service, so we are grateful to have that inspirational addition to the service. And we will have a brief meeting of the council after church. We will be gathering in what used to be our library. If you're a council member, please plan to stay for a couple minutes to participate. Also, today is the day of a special offering for Camp Mount Luther. We do have plates in the back. And of course, this is our only opportunity to support a church camp since the UCC Hartman Center camp has closed. Camp Mount Luther is a beautiful facility, and we want to help to maintain it and support it so that it will be able to remain open and continue providing camping experiences in the beauty of the outdoors for youth through the generations. Okay, also tonight you will notice the festival committee will be meeting here at 6:30. Of course, anyone is willing to come out and help and join those of us who wish to support the festival as it returns this year. This week I will be on vacation. Next Sunday, Reverend Mike Price will be here as our supply pastor, and he has been here numerous times before, and I'm sure that all of you will give him a warm Himmels welcome as he returns to the pulpit. And I do have an on-call pastor, that is Pastor Jody Ellis from St. John's Lechkill. If you need to contact her, please just contact Betty, and she will get in touch with Jody and have her contact you. Okay, other upcoming events in the community, May 27th, that's a week from this Thursday, is the baccalaureate service at Line Mountain High School. We do have several persons from our congregation who will be graduating this year, and that is just open to a certain number of members of the graduates' families, and also will be live streamed, so if anyone wishes to watch the service, and you have all you need is a computer, and you can do that. Also, I want to announce that we are going to be participating in a fundraiser for Linda Smeltz. We've all been praying for her as she deals with the unexpected onset of a very serious health condition. And the fundraiser will be a chicken barbecue on July the 10th, $10 a platter. There is a sign-up sheet that's posted, so if you would like to help out the family, this is an opportunity to do so, and also to enjoy some good chicken barbecue. Any other announcements before we turn to the additions to our prayer list? Okay, we are adding Barb Manning this week. Anyone else who should be added? And I would invite everyone to listen to the prelude and meditate upon the music as we continue to prepare for worship.
Thank you.
Please stand at this time if you are able. Alleluia! Christ is risen.
Christ is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Refreshed by the resurrection life we share in Christ, let us give thanks for the gift of baptism. We thank you, risen Christ, for the waters where you make us new, leading us from death to life, from tears to joy. We bless you, risen Christ, that your Spirit comes to us in the grace-filled waters of rebirth, like rains to our thirsting earth, like streams that revive our souls, like cups of cool water shared with strangers. Breathe your peace on your church when we hide in fear. Clothe us with your mercy and forgiveness. Send us companions on our journey as we share your life. Make us one, risen Christ. Cleanse our hearts. Shower us with life. To you be given all praise with the Holy Spirit in the glory of God, now and forever.
Amen.
Thank you.
Gracious and glorious God, you have chosen us as your own, and by the powerful name of Christ, you protect us from evil. By your Spirit, transform us and your beloved world, that we may find our joy in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Please be seated.
Thank you.
Please stand once more, if you are able, for the reading of today's gospel. The gospel listed in the bulletin was actually from 2 weeks ago, and the gospel for today is John chapter 17, verses 9 through 19. Jesus is speaking to his disciples. I pray for them. I do not pray for the world, but for the men you gave me, because they belong to you. All I have is yours, and all you have is mine, and my glory is shown through them. And now I am coming to you. I am no longer in the world, but they are in the world. O Holy Father, keep them safe by the power of your name, the name you gave me, so they may be one just as you and I are one. While I was with them, I kept them safe by the power of your name, the name you gave me. I protected them, and not one of them was lost except the man who was bound to be lost, that the scripture might come true. And now I am coming to you, and I say these things in the world so that they might have my joy in their hearts. In all its fullness, I gave them your message, and the world hated them because they do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. I do not ask you to take them out of the world, but I do ask you to keep them safe from the evil one. Just as I do not belong to the world, they do not belong to the world. Make them your own by means of the truth. Your word is truth. I sent them into the world just as you sent me into the world. And for their sake, I give myself to you in order that they too may truly belong to you. This is the gospel of our Lord on this day. Please be seated. Well, a local radio personality was discussing his experience. He was on the air after receiving news of the CDC lifting the mask mandate for fully vaccinated people. After he heard this news, he was in the parking lot of a Weiss preparing to go in and get groceries. And he looked at his mask. He was fully vaccinated, so he couldn't decide whether or not he was going to put on the mask. He looked around to see what other grocery shoppers were doing. And then, well, he just decided he was going to wear the mask. You know, that would be more comfortable. And later in the day, he was glad that he did make that decision because he heard through Penn Live, the news feed, that Weiss and Giant are going to continue asking shoppers to mask, at least for the time being. Well, the masks have given all of us kind of a sense of security. They've been a way to cope with the anxiety brought by the epidemic. We just feel a little bit safer knowing that they give us a layer of protection against the airborne virus particles that could make us sick. And they have other benefits as well. I don't know how all of you feel about this, but I kind of figure that when you're wearing a mask, people can't really see your hair. And so there have been a fewer trips on my part to the hairdresser than there were in pre-epidemic times. And I have to say, I'm not facing the same dilemma as that radio personality because I am not removing my mask before I get a good haircut. Well, in our gospel, Jesus prays for his disciples. And we who are his present-day disciples likewise hear him praying for us. He asks for God his Father to protect the disciples whom he has been protecting during those years of his earthly ministry, knowing that his time with them is soon going to end. As his followers, They are in the world, but they are not of the world. Likewise, as his followers, we are in the world, but not of the world. Our highest loyalty is not to the promotion of our own self-interest, but rather is to the building up of God's kingdom. And that gives us a differing angle of vision that might place us in conflict or danger. Certainly the disciples were in danger at the time of Jesus' arrest and trial. They were in need of Jesus' prayers. And in our own way, we too are in need of Jesus' prayers. And we are in need of prayers because we all live with a certain amount of anxiety. The epidemic has brought that home to each of us. Some of us live with fears that lie deep within the recesses of our own minds, like the child who fears there could be monsters and dragons beneath the bed. And that doesn't mean that those fears are any less real, but many of our other fears are rooted in the realities of the world that's around us, come out of the circumstances in which we live. For example, if we live to be very elderly, we will experience declining health at some point. If we are younger, you know, we can't necessarily count on our jobs providing health insurance and a guaranteed steady source of retirement income for our older years. If we have young children or grandchildren, we can't necessarily count on them having the same access to clean air and clean water that we all have come to expect. I mean, anyone been to the ocean recently? Notice how much trash is floating around in the ocean that you never found that so many years ago. These are real fears that we face. There is such a distance between this world in which we live and God's kingdom. But we know how powerful prayer can be. Prayer can help us face our fears. We can pray for one another. And we can take comfort from our gospel in which Jesus prays for all of the disciples, including us. And as Christians, we can do more than face our fears. We can live beyond our fears. We can live well and live fully in spite of our fears. Our passage from 1 John lifts up the eternal life which is given to believers. It is life which is given to us now and which we will carry into eternity. That is something we miss when we read the Gospel of John and the epistles of 1st, 2nd, and 3rd John, because when John speaks of eternal life, it's not just something that's waiting for us out there in the future, but it's also something that we possess in the here and now present of our lives. And that is clearer when you read the Gospel and the epistles in the original Greek language. Now, we just may not feel like, well, eternal life has been given to us now. We just feel like we're so far removed from God's kingdom. We may feel overwhelmed by the realities of our world, the innumerable little demands of our daily lives, the uncertainty over what the future may hold for each of us and for all of us. Well, all of those fears and uncertainties and demands are just part and parcel of life, which all of us will experience. But as Jesus suggests, we are in this world, but not of this world. There is another side to our lives as believers, and on that other side, there is the hope of the faith. The certainty that nothing, not even death, can ever separate us from God's love. On that other side, there is the peace which passes all understanding, which Christ brings to our hearts. On that other side, there is the love of God, which brings us assurance that we are loved by our God, no matter whether the present circumstances of our lives are sunny or are covered in dark clouds. And these things, the hope of our faith, the peace of Christ, the love of God, change us from the inside out. The mask provides a protective layer, but it does not change us at that deep place where anxiety takes root. We, the faithful, can remain calm, even in the midst of anxious circumstances. We, the faithful, can remain focused, even with the reality of those innumerable demands pulling us in so many different directions. We, the faithful, can chart a path forward, even given all of the uncertainties of our futures. Yes, we are people who live in this world, but we are not of this world. May we turn our fears and frustrations over to God, and may we live as people of faith, looking ahead towards God's kingdom. Amen.
Thank you.
once more if you are able. God of love, you call us beloved children and welcome us to your table. Receive our lives and the gifts we offer. Abide with us and send us in service to a suffering world for the sake of your beloved child, Jesus Christ. Amen. And now we confess the faith that does bring to each of us the fullness of eternal life through the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven, is seated at the right hand of the Father, and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now, alive in the risen Christ by the power of the Holy Spirit, we bring our prayers before God, who promises to hear us and answer in steadfast love. Holy God, in Christ Jesus, the joy of the church is made complete. Root the church in your word and unify us as Christ's body. Send us into the world as your loving people, ready to testify to your spirit at work. Hear us, God. Mighty God, the world is your handiwork. Displaying your creativity, seas teem with life, forests reach up to praise you, and the mystery of life lies deep in the soil. Guard and keep this world for the well-being of all of your creatures. Hear us, O God. Gracious Sovereign, those who follow your ways are like trees planted near streams of water. Establish the leaders of nations and all in authority in your grace and truth. Especially we pray for your presence now with those leaders in the Middle East as conflict threatens to rear its ugly head there again, as it has so often through the ages. Strengthen them. Enable them to make the best decisions that may restore peace. Hear us, O God. Generous Savior, you befriend those who are sick, suffering, poor, lonely, outcast, rejected, or sick. Grant healing and love to all in need. Especially we lift before you on this day the need of Barb Manning. May your healing hand rest upon her. And we pray that you might be present with these others whose names and needs we now place before you on our lips and in our hearts. O saving God, your wonderful promise is the gift of eternal life in Jesus. Through the witness of those who have died in you, strengthen us now in this gift of life. Hear us, O God. In the hope of new life in Christ, we raise all of our prayers to you, trusting in your never-ending goodness and mercy. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. And now together, we pray the prayer that our Lord taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. God, grant you a spirit of wisdom to know and to love the risen Lord Jesus. The God of life, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless you now and forever.
Amen.